राइट, दिस अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन और बहुत प्यारा क्वेश्चन. इंटेग्रल ऑफ 3x प्लस वाई बाई अंडर रूट ऑफ 7x प्लस 9 डी एक्स. वेन एवर दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम इज कमिंग, वॉट यू नीड टू डू मीन्स टेक न्यूमरेटर. वॉट इज न्यूमरेटर हियर? 3x प्लस 5 इज इक्वल टू, राइट दैट न्यूमरेटर एज a इंटू 7x प्लस 9 प्लस b. You write a into 7x plus 9 plus b. Now we need to manipulate. So what happens here? 3x plus 5 is equal to 7ax plus 9a plus b. Now I think we can compare constants on both the sides. After comparing the constants, what we'll be getting here, I'm writing, I take this part as rough, and what I'll be getting, I'll be getting b as 5. And now I'll be comparing the, I'll be getting what? 9a plus b as 5. 9a plus b as 5, because this is the constant part in our problem. And if I compare coefficient of x compare mane to, kya jata? 7a is equal to 3 for us. If you could observe carefully, coefficient of x is 7a here and coefficient of x is 3. So 7a is equal to 3. Finally, if I get 7a is equal to 3, means a I can write blindly as 3 by 7, because 7 goes to that side. Now I'll be putting this particular a value in this particular equation. That means if I call this a star, I'll be putting this particular a equal to 3 by 7 in star. Therefore, what happens? A star implies 9 into 3 by 7 plus b is equal to 5. So 9 into 3 means 27, 27 by 7. So b is equal to 5 minus, I can write as 27 by 7. And 7 will be the LCM. 5 7s are 35. 35 minus 27. 35 minus 27 will be 8 by 7. So finally, what I got here, a value is 3 by 7 and b value is 8 by 7. So I can utilize this particular a value and b value in equation 1. Therefore, what happens finally? Therefore, 1 implies 3x plus 5 is equal to, in place of a, I can write as 3 by 7 into 7x plus 9, and in b ki jagah mein 8 by 7. But here, if you could observe carefully, the function is 3x plus 5 by under root of 7x plus 9. So, what I'll be doing means, I'll be dividing this particular equation by under root of 7x plus 9. So what happens finally? 3 by 7 into 7x plus 9 divided by under root of 7x plus 9 plus 8 by 7 into under root of 7x plus 9. And later to this particular equation, if I apply integration, I think RHS will be the net result to the given problem. So what happens? Integral of 3x plus 5 divided by under root of 7x plus 9 dx is equal to 3 by 7 into integral of, I think it is looking like a by root a. A by root a means a can be written as root a into root a. So one root a will be getting cancelled. And finally, there remains 7x plus 9 dx, and here 8 by 7 will be coming outside, and this can be written as under root of 7x plus 9. Under root of 7x plus 9 going up means it becomes as 7x plus 9 minus 1 by 2 dx. So if you could observe carefully, I'll be repeating the process right from the beginning. Whenever this kind of problem comes, we need to write 3x plus 5 is equal to a into 7x plus 9 plus b. And later we need to compare the terms on both LHS and RHS. I compared here constant. So I got 9a plus b is equal to 5. I called that one as star. And I compared coefficient of x. So I got 7a is equal to 3. So a equal to 3 by 7. Later, I'll be putting this particular a in this star. Therefore, 9 into 3 by 7 plus b is equal to 5. So, b equal to 8 by 7. So, I got the values of a as well as b, and I'll be putting in equation 1. After substituting, I divided by under root of 7x plus 9 and I apply integral. I think the procedure is clear up to here. Right. Now later what I'll be doing, I think you copied up to here. Now I'll be going for the next step. Right. If you could observe carefully, 3 by 7 into integral of under root of 7x plus 9. It is looking like root x. Root x means x power 1 by 2. X power 1 by 2 kya form le ra? X power n. So what I'll be doing means, here that is equal to 3 by 7. For your convenience and for my comfort, I am writing this as whole power 1 by 2. So later, and again this also integral of, and here for us 8 by 7 will be there. I had forgotten. 8 by 7 integral of 7x plus 9 whole key power minus 1 by 2 dx. So what happens, that is equal to 3 by 7. If you could see here, it is like x power 1 by 2. X power 1 by 2 means I can write as 7x plus 9 whole power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1. But whatever coefficient of x is there, that comes in terms of denominator. Similarly, here also 8 by 7, 7x plus 9 whole power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1, and coefficient of x 7 is there, that comes to denominator. So later what happens, 3 by 7, 7x plus 9 whole power 3 by 2, here 1 by 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2, 3 by 2 into 7 plus 8 by 7 into 7x plus 9 whole power 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 into 7. I think still we can do manipulation here. Here what happens? I think 1, 3 will be getting cancelled and 2 is going up. So it becomes as 2 by 49, 7x plus 9 whole power 3 by 2. And here also 2 going up, 1 by 2 means it becomes as 16. 16 by 49 into 7x plus 9 whole power 1 by 2. So finally, we can leave the problem. But here always remember, there should be C because it's an indefinite integration. So finally, 2 by 49 into 7x plus 9 whole power 3 by 2 plus 16 by 49 into 7x plus 9 whole power 1 by 2 plus C. Right. Now we are seeing method of transformation. Method of transformation may, we are seeing type 1 problems. Type 1 problem means we can call it as a basic problems also. Now, when coming to this particular function, if you could observe carefully, integral of x square by 1 plus x square dx. There is no formula involved here. Or we can't apply u by v rule like that of differentiation, because here we are using the concept of integration. So here we need to think in a little bit manner. How we can think means, I'll be giving a tip. Here 1 plus x square is there, but in a numerator there is a term called x square. So for x square, if I add 1 and subtract 1, I think we are getting some beautiful message by adding 1 or subtracting 1. So what I'll be doing means, everyone observe carefully, I will add 1 to x square and subtract 1 to x square, so that there will be no loss to our function. And here it is becoming as 1 plus x square dx. Now again, it is like A, it is like B, it is like C. So A minus B by C. A minus B by C means I can write it as 1 plus x square by 1 plus x square dx minus integral of 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square will be getting cancelled. So integral of dx minus 1 by 1 plus x square dx. Now integral of dx means I can write as x, and integral of 1 by 1 plus x square we discussed earlier. There is a formula for 1 by 1 plus x square. What is that formula? Tan inverse x plus c. Right. What that formula also, once again I am writing. So, but before writing that, I'll be giving the answer. x square by 1 plus x square dx is nothing but x minus tan inverse x plus c. What is the formula here we used? Means integral of, here I am giving it as a note beta, everyone you can copy. Integral of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is nothing but what? Tan inverse x plus c. Just we have applied here. Integral of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to tan inverse x plus c. Right. That means our mind should work a lot. That means we should observe the problem carefully. If we are not able to find integral by using the formula, we need to see we can convert it in our known formula or known method or not. So for that I added plus 1 or minus 1. I think now you are clear with this particular problem. So I'll be going for the next problem. Right. Now if you could observe carefully, it is like x power 4 plus 1 upon x square plus 1 dx. So what I'll be doing here also, no formula for us. And what many people will be doing in a hurry means they'll be doing a plus b by c. That means a by c plus b by c. Again it becomes tedious, the procedure becomes very long, and sometimes you may win in this battle or not. So what I'll be doing means integral of x power 4, this one I'll be writing it as minus 1 plus 2. So very beautifully we'll be getting. So this I'll be writing it as x square plus 1 dx. So what happens finally? If you could observe carefully, again this is a, this is b, this is c. So a by c plus b by c. So what happens? X power 4 minus 1 by x square plus 1 dx plus integral of 2 by x square plus 1 dx. So finally what happens? If you could observe carefully this also, x power 4 minus 1. X power 4 minus 1 means it is like x square minus 1 into x square plus 1, because there is a formula a square minus b square is equal to a minus b into a plus b. So I will be writing this as x square minus 1 into x square plus 1 divided by x square plus 1, and here there will be always be dx, and 2 will be coming outside, and there remains 1 by x square plus 1 dx. Now x square plus 1 will be getting cancelled. Finally, there remains integral of x square minus 1 dx, and here also 2 into integral of 1 by x square plus 1 dx. I think by this time you are familiar with the formulas. You can tell blindly, integral of x square minus 1 dx means integral of x square. Alag se karna. So what is that? X cube by 3, and minus will be coming outside, and integral of dx will be x plus 2 into, just now I said in previous problem, integral of 1 by 1 plus x square dx is nothing but tan inverse x plus c. So what happens? 2 into tan inverse x plus c. I think you are clear with this problems. Right. So up till now we have done some problems based on transformations. Transformations may we have done type 1 problems. Now in the next class we'll be seeing type 2 problems. Right.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.